G'day, how you going? This is Ian Harris from Australia here, and today we're going to do this painting that I said we'll do on my live video on Facebook. That's what I sketched up with yous, and that's what I'm going to paint today. But before I get on with this video, I want to say a special hello to a couple of people in British Columbia, Canada. There are a few followers of mine, and they get together and have a class and paint all my videos, and that inspires me to keep doing this, and in turn do my work and share it around. It works both ways. It's wonderful. So we'll just say hello to Christy Moore. G'day, Christy Moore. You and your friends are doing well out there. Michelle Ferguson, she sits down with Christy Moore and paints a few of my moon paintings. And Devon Taylor. Now, these girls are from British Columbia in Canada. And, you know, they're not bad either. They're quite spicy and they know how to paint. But they get the chance to sit down and paint. Well, I've got to stand up and paint today. So let's have some fun and get on with the colours we're going to use here today, okay? We have black, dioxine purple, mid-yellow, white, burnt sienna, yellow oxide, sap green, yellow green. I use my 2-inch blending brush. I use the flat filbert brush. I use my fan brush. We use the knife, use your whatever knife you want. I use the flat brush for scenery and a bigger one. And also retarder. All right, now we're using the acrylic, so we're starting off. I've got the gloves on because I want to wear them. I don't like paint getting on my skin. Over the years, it gets into your blood system. It can create all sorts of cancers and whatnot. That's why I wear gloves, but also I want to wear them, okay? When I take them off, my hands are clean. Now we got a canvas here that's 45 centimeters by 60 centimeters, okay? Now, and we're doing acrylic, so this is dry, fresh out of the packet, okay? And we're gonna use acrylic. So, water, I've just put simple water onto the canvas, all right? Now I've got my cheap flowing artist's fine paint here. It's just white, simple white. Something I can put a little dollop of white with, put a bit of water, and down here, I've got retarder on mixed in with the paint, and this is going to be the prime base for our canvas, okay? Now why good old Ian went along and wet the canvas first, lets this paint flow, it's not dragging, and you've got to put more and more on, okay? And the retarder that I'm putting on there is going to keep this white prime, gesso, whatever you want to call it, wet. So this is what you do. Now we get on to the next colour. Alrighty, we're getting our yellow, okay? Bit of retarder in it. We're going to make this guy just a bit of yellow down on the bottom near the water line, okay? Where's our water line? About there. Blend it down into nothing. Same as there. Now the blue with this is probably going to give it a green tinge. All right, now we're going to do the same with the sexy phthalo blue. We're putting a bit of retarder in it and we are going to paint the sky blue, okay? So we'll start in the middle, all the way across the canvas if we can. Start bringing it down here and bringing it down here. Look what that retarder's done. It's allowed me to keep going. If this was all dry, no retarder, this would not have happened. Now I want to blend all this blue, get it into that yellow. Now we don't want that so much yellow. All right, we've finished blending. Now we're going to get the dioxine purple, bit of retarder in there on the brush, and give us some darky bits around where we're going to have some clouds and the corners. Put it on, smash your brush dry on a rag, blend this into the blue. While you're blending it, leave some dark bits as you go, see? Don't blend it all as one smeared blend, if you know what I mean. You want some dark bits in there, because that's going to highlight the clouds. We'll do the other side as well. So just mainly there. Wipe that in a rag. You don't have to wash it out, just wipe it in a rag. But if it's too messy, now see the brush I'm using, I'm not using my filbert, I'm using this 2-inch again, and I'm lightly blending this purple dioxane into that sexy phthalo blue, leaving tones of dark and light bits with it, okay? Like I did to the other side there, not blending it all into one concentrated smear of a blur, a blend I mean. Because it's nice when you get all these different light and dark tones in there, okay? Alrighty, I'm getting my fan brush and the white Mary Ballering. How you going, Mary? These are the people that commented on this design of this painting. So they're all going to get a mention in it. Mary Strickland Quinn, she's a great friend of mine. Now, we're going to do like a porthole of clouds in this, like I said. So we've got our paint on there with the fan brush. And look at what I've just done there. Now we're going to do a porthole of, keep them coming down. Put that down. Blend that. Maybe, yeah, see the retarders washes it in a bit too much sometimes. Okay, there's our next piece. Oh, I forgot to have the blend this in. Oh yeah, that's lovely. Blend the bottom of that cloud in. Blend into the atmosphere, across the horizon line. Somewhere our horizon line is going to be there. See, I want a low horizon line. You can put your horizon line wherever you want it. Now we'll do this side of porthole clouds. First I'll use the piece with retarder in it. We're going to say hello to Christy Moore again. Said hello to Christy Moore. Tammy Bray Brown, Deborah Weaver, and Angela Maxwell. How yous all going out there? Yous all commented on this. You want a big see how I put that on? It doesn't look much like a cloud, but when you're blending from here out and different pressures as you're doing it, don't put it on the one pressure and blend it into oblivion. It'll look like, sorry to say, but shit. Okay, so what you're doing, let's just put a bit of that white back on there. What you're doing is you're blending soft and light and really getting this edge blended in to smoothness. So it's like a ramp. You're going up to the good textured paint and you are doing it soft. Porthole, we're making porthole pattern. Okay, blend that down into the atmosphere, different pressures, it's so easy. And you're getting light and dark paints everywhere. Then we blend that, hang on, I've got a big blob there. We'll blend this same way I just showed you. Not so hard, not so heavy. Can't go wrong. See, I'm putting bits of highlight on here now. See, a bit more there just to make that stand out. Now remember, this was just a design I wanted to design and paint along with you, okay? If you want to paint along with this, you're welcome, but this one's not a lesson how to paint. It's just me painting this one for you. All right, we've pretty much got our big pillowy fluffy clouds, and just to make them stand out, we'll put some highlights on them. G'day, Michael Dijalis. He's an American Indigenous Indian. He does a lot of Indigenous stuff. Look him up on my friends list. He put some good art up there as well. Now I'm just, as you can see, pressing some highlights just to make some sit backwards and forwards of each other. I'm going to use this brush that I bought today. It's a flat, hard bristled brush, and I'm going to use it like a scenery brush. So it's pretty much the, I'm going to add a bit of, just a little spray of water with me dioxine purple. And over here, I think we're going to have a, where do I want my horizon line? Probably about here. So I'm going to go across. See, it needs to be a bit wetter. That way it'll spread from your brush onto the canvas. Okay. Now we're going to come across here. Get it up and down, up and down. This is just a small bit on this side of the painting. Up and down, up and down. Probably, how far do we want to go? Just about there. We don't want to go too far across the painting. Now we'll get a little bit of white just to highlight some of that. Not too much. Just so it's got a soft highlight to it to break it up, so it's not such a boring. And we'll start from there. That's all it is. Keep this straight, pull it down. We're doing this while the bottom's still wet, because this is acrylic, don't forget. Okay, and then you turn your brush around and lightly go that way as well. Oh, if you make that noise, oh, there you go. All right, I'll grab me flat filbert. I'm getting the black paint. Now this black paint, let's see how it goes without any water in it. I'm going across the top of where I want my hill. All right, we pretty much got that all blacked in now, and we got to dry it. But before we dry it, I want to pull down probably the reflection here, which is not much, but we just want something to resemble the reflection in the water, which is there. All right, before we dry it though, I want to put our white line there on the knife, and this is an easy way to load up your knife. Okay, so you got your paint on your palette there, just pull it down into a sheet over the board, over the easel, right? Not the easel. Pull it down into a sheet over your palette, okay? Clean your knife again, and then what you're doing, you're putting it on the edge into there, and just sliding it through it, okay? Keeping all that edge onto the paint as you've done it, and you'll have a beautiful roll of paint on your knife, okay? Because all this watercolor is still wet. Okay, so I've just put that there like so, but before I finish up, I've got to sink these reflections of, I'll do them later, otherwise I'll end up mucking them up. Right, I'm getting this big brush, and I'm gonna slowly blend them into the water and do those number eights here, and then blend that, because this is our shine of the moon on top of the water. That'll do. Where was I? Anyway, we got our horizon line. Ready to put our moon in. Before we put the moon on and dry everything, I'll get the white, and like you always need a bit of mist in your sky, put a bit on and blend it. Remember, this is just mist. Blend it, tweak it. Can you see that okay? Yeah. Do a bit at a time, because if your paint's dried, you don't want to have looking half blended. That's it. Beautiful. Just do a bit at a time, smash it on. And it's always good to do these in like a bit of an R pattern, like you're doing an R. Not an exact R, but to that, if you know what I mean. Okay, there's enough. I put too much on that one, but that doesn't matter. And that's roughly where our moon's gonna sit, okay? Okay, we've got our moon cut out, and I want me moon about here. That'll do. Okay, we'll tape him on so he won't fall off. And we'll rattle off a few more names. Anne Keel, how are you, Anne? Laurie Cass, Gail Schultz, Nancy Strange, and Wanda Castorese. How yous all doing there? Thanks for your comments there. April Wilson, Angela Maxwell again, Anne Marie Kuncha. I'm not sure how you pronounce that, but here's some names here that came along the comments on this. Okay, we're getting our white. The white does not need, see how this template's, someone's gone and made a plastic board. They had a plastic board and they've cut out different sizes for their moons. That's a good idea. Now, we're gonna have our moon. So, where are we? With your moon, for God's sake, don't think about it. Just get the damn thing on there. You can twist it. Oh, careful there, Annie Barberini. Now, I just want a bit of gray into that as well, a dark gray. So you're turning the sponge around and getting some dark gray onto your sponge there. Now, you got a dark section of the moon. Get all this and blend it, whatever. You've used that white to create a primer virtually. Then go back to your white again, and then you finish it off. So we want a nice, tight edge of white there. And if you don't get that, that doesn't matter. You can make that up with brush detailing at the end of the painting if you want to do some more brush detail. But we'll have a look at that, if I can get the damn thing off without smearing anything. How's that look? Simple moon, huh? Now see the mist and the clouds we put there? We want to bring them back. Now we've gone and blow dried the moon, so as we can bring that mist in. But Neville Baker, I want to say hello to Neville Baker, Pat Ray, Christy Wicker actually, Anne Marie Grant Scott. Now let's put these glares back into the moon. So you got your white again. And where are we? You want to glare in front of it. Quickly get your brush and blend that. It's what it's doing. It's sinking the moon back into the sky. Get a bit more here. We'll get a bit more, I don't know, just down around here so it doesn't look so uniform. Now we're going to get onto this. Say hello to Kenny Bohas and Semi Riley. We've pretty much done everything there except for small details. Now we're going to, what was the next thing we're going to do? Oh, we've got to do this now. So did I dry that? Yeah, that's dry. So let's get some colours into this now, okay? Now we're going to grab some burnt sienna. That black's been dried now. Grab some on your knife there, and from the top, let's sort of find a way of getting this down, leaving some blacks. Looking in the camera, if I have a look, I can get a. That's fine, okay, I'm happy with that. Now dry the damn thing. Right, now she's dry, we're going to get some yellow oxide, stipple it onto your knife and try and see what you can do with it. Actually, you know what I might do? I might grab my big knife, this one, and there's my yellow oxide. I'll pull it out. I'll stipple it on up and down. So we're like that. Then we'll, like I did on some mountains before, we're just getting a, but you don't want it to be an even pattern. Now wipe the damn thing and stipple it again. How's that looking? That's looking all right, eh? That's simple. That's a good way for beginners to learn rocks until they get the gist of folding shadows and everything within rocks, because shadows have their own folds and depths and shadows. How's that looking in there? That's not too bad. Just finish stippling the white onto your blade and finding those areas that need highlighting. Now we're grabbing our dark colour. What the hell is it? Alright, we're highlighting . Okay, I've dried this black piece. I've gotten my green on my scenery brush with a little bit of water working out so it'll transfer from the brush onto the canvas. And I'm just using a sap green here. Okay, so we'll use our sap green. And I want to leave darkness between the rocks and the edge, okay? I don't want it too cartoony looking though. This is just going to be like a green field. Alrighty, now we'll get our yellow green, stamp it onto your scenery brush the same way, and get it on there over the top of this sap green, leaving bits of the sap green. I'll come a bit closer. You got to understand though, for me to come closer, makes it bloody hard to paint, but that's what painting's all about. See, sort of go up and down, make crevices in your land, because that what you're putting there is land. But see all these dots? Get rid of them, stamp over them so it's not so uniformy, okay? All right, we're getting some of the sap, not the sap, we're getting some of the yellow green and just sort of dribbling it up the rock a bit, but I'm doing it mainly over the black areas, okay? Now we're just going to highlight that yellow green, but dry it first. Now we've got our yellow. We're going to highlight this green with the minimalist of yellow, not too much. And then to get the dull and brighter bits, we'll be highlighted with a bit of white into this yellow. Bit up there. Because this, the yellow green and this yellow's highlighting on top of it, is the actual grass there. Let's get down and have a, you can see, I'll bring it up for you. See what we're doing? We're getting on the land and then coming down. Don't just put it there and come down like that. You want to blend it into the land, okay? And then see how it's hovering over the edge, but you've left black in between for the bank. So we come along, boom, 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 get some into the water there. Righty, we'll finish it off with this foreground here, eh? So I've got one of my new scenery brushes here. Give it a bit of water to spread. And this is just the dioxine purple into the stabbed up and down into the scenery brush. And we'll come along from about here. And if anything, we're going to bring it into a V. Anyway, we've highlighted that. It's wet. It's wet as buggery, but our tree, should we put a tree in it? 9 times out of 10, when I put a tree in it, I stuff up me bloody pictures, eh? So I'm not putting a tree in it now on camera, but later on, if when I've got the time and the mood and a cuppa, or not a cuppa, but me box of coffee. Oh, that's beautiful, man. I'll do details like that, you know, like sharpening up the moon, putting some stars in there. But for now, I have to take a photo of this for the thumbnail of the video. So that'll be it. Now, I hope you've liked this painting. You've watched me design it. You've watched me paint it. If you want to give this design a go, give it a go. And have fun painting it. Share it around. Get it out there, okay? Now, like I said, know what you're going to paint before you paint something, because it's very horrible to try and paint something and you don't know what you're going to paint. You end up going all over the place and giving up. Now, I've just pulled this design out of my head, so this is going to be another one of my designs, okay? Thanks for watching. Share, like, and subscribe my videos. This has been Ian Harris saying goodbye, good luck, and good on ya.